Beowulf is considered to be the first epic poem of English literature. The writer of this heroic poem is unanimous. It said this epic was transported to English land around 780 by the Germanic tribes who are called Norsemen. This piece of poems tells the story of bravery and loyalty to the king, and also revenge and death centers around this grand poem. If we want to interpret this poem, we need to have basic knowledge on few major issues of this poem, like major places of the incidences, major characters, and also major themes. The development of this poem involves two major places, Geatsland and Danesland. Beowulf is the prince of Geatsland, and the royal family has a relation with Danesland, where King Hrothgar rules. Prince Beowulf's father once saved Danesland from danger, and thus Beowulf feels an urge to protect this land when his land of Hrothgar once was beset with troubles. If we want to have a look on major characters, we get a few of them. Then let us have a quick review of the major characters, some of its immemorable character traits, which are analyzed below. Beowulf. Beowulf is the protagonist of the epic poem and demonstrates traits of heroism and extreme physical strength. He fights the demon Grendel, then kills his mother, and finally fights the dragon. Beowulf also displays other character traits such as fearlessness when he attacks Grendel. He also shows his pride and courtesy when he speaks to the king of Danes and other courtiers. In the third battle with the dragon, he once again displays his extreme courage and bravery and fights it until his death. He then hands over the kingdom of Geats to his comrade Wiglaf, advising him to care for the kingdom and people. King Hrothgar. King Hrothgar is the second major character, living in peace after uniting the tribes which are at war with his ancestors. King Hrothgar is brave, generous, and honest, and has won battles to bring peace in his land. When Grendel appears and terrorizes his people, Beowulf extends his help to Hrothgar. In the epic poem, he is most famous for building the popular hall Eorath, where Grendel, the monster, killed the Danes. Grendel. Grendel is the third most important character. Grendel is a monster and descendant of Cain from the Bible. He is capable of thinking and acting like a human being. He first appears in Hrothgar's hall of Eorath and kills several Danes merely for singing. Beowulf then comes to Denmark and offers to help Hrothgar to get rid of Grendel. In a duel, Beowulf severs his head and ends his terror. And mother of Grendel. Grendel's mother is a second antagonist in the epic story. She doesn't have a name, but is commonly addressed as a monster and Grendel's mother. She attacks Eorath Hall to exact revenge for her son's murder. Beowulf is again assigned to find her. He discovers that she lives in a cave under the lake and is stuck in a 9 hours fierce battle with Grendel's mother. After knowing that his sword, Ranting, cannot kill Grendel's mother, Beowulf finds an ancient sword that he uses to kill her. Despite her importance, it's very interesting that she has not been named by the anonymous author of this epic poem. And dragon. The dragon is the last antagonist in the epic. Beowulf, who becomes the reason for Beowulf's death and almost destroys the Geats race. He appears when Beowulf is older and had been ruling the Geats for several years. He has brought peace and happiness to his people. However, one day, a slave enters the lair of the dragon and steals his cup. The dragon wakes up and starts burning homes, killing everyone in the path while searching for the thief. Beowulf takes his things and starts his search for the dragon. Finally, he finds it in its lair and fights him with his young companion, Wiglaf. Beowulf is fatally wounded after killing the dragon and die. Then theme of Beowulf, loyalty. Beowulf celebrates a warrior culture. For this reason, loyalty is of paramount importance. One of the central points which demonstrates this is the conflict between Beowulf and Unferth. Beowulf is from another place and another tribe. His allegiance to Hrothgar is through a family debt, yet he proves himself more loyal to Hrothgar than Unferth, who is one of Hrothgar's own men. As Beowulf distinguishes his loyalty to the king, Unferth fails. The real test of the hero is his loyalty to the king, to knightly virtue, and to his honesty, and bravery and valor. Beowulf is the perfect embodiment of bravery and valor. He shows no fear and never wavers from his quest throughout the poem. As a warrior knight, his only choice is to act and to never show fear in the face of adversity. As a matter of bravery, few lines may be recited here. Beowulf, son of Ecgtheow, spoke, "Wise sir, do not grieve. It's always better to avenge their wounds than to indulge in mourning. For every one of us living in this world means waiting for our end." Vengeance. Again, the Danes and Geats are part of a warrior culture. While engaging in battle is a necessary feature of life, Grendel's mother shows no allegiance to anyone or anything other than her thirst for revenge. Grendel is also a figure of blind vengeance. He kills and terrorizes simply for the thirst for blood, generosity and hospitality. Even as the poem draws our attention to feats of valor and strength, there is almost as much emphasis on the generous hospitality offered by King Hrothgar and his wife. The feasts and celebrations are as detailed as the battles. After his victories, Beowulf is treated with songs about his strength and bravery. The storylines of this grand poem tends to reveal that the ruler must keep his people safe and rule justly. The two most important examples of this theme are King Hrothgar and Beowulf. Both are very popular among their people. Hrothgar felt obliged to entertain his Danes, so he builds the mead hall where all Danes can enjoy and sing. Beowulf took responsibility for the safety of all the Geats' tribes for several years. His obligation to cost his life when he fights the dragon. Hence, rulers at any period or position are obliged to protect their people.